A young man has taken the country by storm, risking his life in an effort to save the lives of babies in the womb. Who is this man? He's come to be known as Pro-Life Spider-Man. He's climbed several skyscrapers, most recently scaling the 40-story tall Chase Tower in Arizona. When he successfully reached the top, he was taken into police custody. There was a crowd cheering the climber on at the bottom of the tower. What's his motivation? Mason says he wants to encourage women facing an unplanned pregnancy to live in faith, not fear. Joining me now is the man who has come to be known as Pro-Life Spider-Man, Mason Deschamps. Spider-Man, hello. Thanks for joining Pro-Life Weekly. It's great to see you. Talk to me about your latest climb, and you know, you scaled the Chase Tower in Arizona. It's 40 stories and it measures at 483 feet tall. How did you do it?
Yeah, you know, I don't really like to use stories as a way to measure, because the Aria in Las Vegas is 60 stories, and that's 600 feet. But the Salesforce Tower in San Francisco is 61 stories, and that's 1,070 feet. So I like to use feet. This one was about 480 feet, and there was a little crevice, right? And it was maybe like about four feet wide. And I use a technique called stemming, where I have my left hand and my left foot on one side and my right hand and my right foot on the other. And I just press, just sort of scooch all the way up until you're at the top.
That's unbelievable. You've got to be really strong to be able to do that. We've talked a little bit about how you did it, but Mason, why did you do it? What first motivated you to start scaling these buildings?
Yeah, I got involved in the pro-life movement back in May, and I had heard the story about the Justice for the Five with the babies in D.C. who were just brutally murdered by Cesare Santangelo. Mm. And when I saw that, not only did the police not arrest the abortionist, but arrested my friends Lauren Handy instead, I just felt convicted. I felt like I needed to get involved in the movement, and being a rock climber, you know, this was my sort of way to use the gifts God gave me. And it's been pretty blessed, because you can see the kind of media attention that comes with this. And I'm able to put that into the pro-life movement, as well as raise money for women in crisis pregnancy. So it's been quite the experience.
Yeah, you're really sounding the alarm on this issue. And speaking of arrests, you were arrested after your most recent climb. What was your reaction to that? And how did the police treat you upon your arrest?
Yeah, you know, I'm arrested almost every time. I've gotten away once, and I wouldn't call it get away. There was just no one that saw me climb, and so I got to the top, and I was like, well, I guess I let myself out the front door then. I don't know. And this time, yeah, the police, they treated me very nice. The fire department treated me very nice, but of course, jail is not so nice. They took me in, and they held me for about 30 hours, and in jail, you know, you're cold, you're tired, you're hungry. And of course, I just got done doing a 500-foot rock climb. So I'm especially cold and tired and hungry. And they bring you out the food, and it's this hard roll, you know, hard as a rock. And they give you the worst peanut butter I've ever had in my life. And as a rock climber, I've eaten some peanut butter in my days, but now this peanut butter was, oof, like cement.
Wow.
But, you know, you want to sleep, and you ask for a blanket, and I think the guard said, no, what do you think this is, a Burger King? So there's definitely some struggle there, but you look at what's happening in these babies, and you look at the truth of what abortion is, and it's murder. And if it's really murder, then we need to act like it. So any sort of sacrifice that we can make is nothing if that's what it takes to save a life.
Hmm. Mason Deschamps, Pro-Life Spider-Man, thanks for joining us. We're praying for you.
Thank you.